Testis cancer is luckily not very common, but it's probably the most common solid tumor, solid growth of an organ that occurs in a young person. The most it most frequently occurs in young people, particularly in their teens, in their 20s, and sometimes in their 30s. Isolated men in their 60s will also get testis cancer. The best thing about testis cancer is probably the most curable solid cancer around. The cure rates are over 95%, so that's the best thing. But you have to get to the doctor and get treated appropriately to get the benefit of such excellent care. And we here at the University of Minnesota have been involved in developing new treatments and diagnostic tools for testis cancer for a long time. Several of the initial studies with established different types of blood tests that can identify testis cancer were developed here. Understanding of the disease process and ways to avoid side effects of surgery were developed here. So we've had an interest in testis cancer for a long time. New approaches to chemotherapy were also developed here. We were among several institutions that initially developed all the new chemo treatments that were very good for testis cancer that stand to this day. And the first thing is, you know, the good thing about testis cancer also is that it's easy to detect. It's a lump in a testicle. Many people detect it fairly early, but you'd still be surprised. You know, some people come in, and I've seen men with testicles that are 14, 15 centimeters, and I'm not sure why they haven't sought care from their doctor, but, you know, so there are those anomalies, but typically most men come in fairly quickly as soon as they identify something's wrong with them, and it involves removing the testicle. Sometimes that's all you need to do. Sometimes you need to treat them with additional radiation, or you may need to treat them with additional chemotherapy. And depending on the type of testis cancer, there's two major types. They're called seminomas and non-seminomas. And now depending on which group or category of tumors they fall into, you adopt different types of treatment. One, seminomas typically is surgical removal of the testicle followed by radiation. Non-seminomas most often involve surgical removal of the testicle and chemotherapy. So that is what decides what type of treatment. And these patients need long-term follow-up to make sure that their testis cancer doesn't come back either somewhere else in their body or in the other testicle. And there are certain people who are more at risk for getting these cancers, particularly if they've had a testicle that has had to be brought down. It was not down in the scrotum in the first place, and so forth.